When they coined the phrase beauty, brains, and talent, they must have been talking about Loren Rabinowitz. First, the beauty part. Loren competed in the 2009 Miss Massachusetts and reached the semifinals. Undaunted, she tried again next year and won the title and the right to represent Massachusetts in the 2011 Miss America pageant. Her platform for the event was fighting childhood hunger. And while she didn't win the title, she was awarded the Children's Miracle Network's Miss Miracle Maker title for raising the most money for charity while competing. Now the brains part. With a high school degree from Buckingham Brown and Nichols Day School and a bachelor's degree from Harvard University, where she double majored in pre-medical studies and English, Loren was awarded the David McCord Prize for depth of talent in the literary arts, in particular, for the combination of the fields of medicine and poetry, and the LeBaron Prize for work as a humanitarian and poet. A third-generation Holocaust survivor and active Hillel student, Loren has been committed to making the world a better place, one person at a time. And last, but certainly not least, comes the talent. Both on and off the ice, Loren has been nothing but extraordinary. This classically trained pianist was also one of America's top ice dancing talents. Beginning at the age of 2 when she hit the ice for the first time, Loren went on to competitions on a solo level until 1995, when United States Olympic coach Natalie Dubova scouted her an event in Lake Placid and decided to pair her with ice dancer David Mitchell. Mitchell, who was living in upstate New York at the time, would move to the Boston area, and for the next decade, the pair would train and compete together, often with Loren's parents coming along and taking their time out to find the Jewish communities in whichever national or international city they were in. They won their first title at the 1999 North American Novice Challenge Skate in Toronto. They would go on to record a total of 4 national medals in 4 years, including a bronze medal at the 2004 U.S. Figure Skating Championships. Their goal was to reach the 2006 Olympics in Torino, Italy, but unfortunately an injury to the team caused them to miss that opportunity. For normal people, this might have been devastating, but Loren took it in stride, committing herself to her philanthropic work and the hope of obtaining a medical degree. Her parents, who are both doctors in the Boston area, have sparked Loren's interest in medicine, and she has spent a lot of time volunteering at hospitals in the Boston area while studying at Harvard. In addition, Loren has also spent countless hours at a center for malnourished children with her mother in Barbados. Loren Rabinowitz, the 2011 Marty Glickman Outstanding Jewish Scholastic Athlete of the Year.
I was actually Hi everyone, I'm so incredibly honored to be here today for a couple of reasons specifically. First of all, one of the major things that I've done during my year as Miss Massachusetts is to talk about the fact that I'm Jewish, of course, but I'm also the grandchild of Holocaust survivors. So my connection to Marty Glickman's not being able to participate in the 1936 Olympics really hits home for me. Also because I didn't make an Olympic team, but more importantly because it was a time and a circumstance that my own family went through in an incredibly devastating way. And I think one of the most incredible moments for me this year was getting to call my 90-year-old grandfather up, who's now living in Texas, and tell him that I had become Miss Massachusetts. And I think for them it was sort of this sense that they had come here, they had come to America, having lost everything in the Holocaust. And I was almost sort of the icing on the cake, but what my grandmother and my grandfather sort of felt was the embodiment of the American dream. So I think another thing that is so wonderful about this award is that it's a combination of both athletics and academics. My grandmother actually passed away in the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina, and my grandparents came here and grew up with my aunt and my mother, who are here today in the audience, in New Orleans, where they were sort of the keystones of the Jewish community in New Orleans. And I think if my grandmother could be here today, she would be almost as proud that I was winning this award as if I was even being inducted. The one thing, I wish I could say that my grandmother was the most supportive person of my figure skating career. I think she was. She used to have viewing parties whenever I was on ESPN with all of her friends down in New Orleans. But the phone call I always got was, "The dress has to be so skimpy. I don't know. Look at my fabric, you know." But I think the thing for her was she was supportive of my athletic career only insofar as it didn't jeopardize my commitment to academics. When you've lost your family, when you've lost your belongings, when you've lost everything you know, you realize that the only thing you never lose is what's in between your own ears, which is what my grandmother always used to say to me. And so I'm incredibly proud to have graduated from Harvard last year, and I'm actually heading down to New York, and I'm going to be at Columbia for medical school next fall. So, although I have to say, the closest I'll probably ever get to being a New York fan is rooting for the Mets. So, I think the other thing that every Jewish athlete has, which is sort of our secret weapon, is a Jewish mother. Now, when you're on the ice or on the field 6 to 8 hours a day, it's really important that you get proper nutrition, which, as we all know, is a Jewish mother's number one priority. But for me, I wouldn't have had the kind of figure skating career that I had without my mother. And I promised her I wouldn't get choked up. But it was something that we got to do together. My mom and I traveled all over the world. We made trips to China, to Japan, we went to Norway, we went to Bulgaria, Spain to study flamenco. It was this incredible journey that was sort of something we did together. And honestly, one of the major reasons I decided to do Miss Massachusetts was because I really missed spending a lot of time with my mom, and I knew that that was going to be something that we would get to do together. And I think the moment that I was most proud of was never winning a national title. It was the moment I finished a program and I would look out into the audience and catch my mom's eye. And she had this look of extraordinary pride, and no judges' marks had come up yet. So it couldn't have been because I won. It was just, it was this sense of love and of support and of her really allowing me to fulfill my passions. And that's sort of something that I think every Jewish athlete is so incredibly lucky.